I'm frustrated
I
today
think.
because there are guys out there selling their feet pics and claiming that they're girls. Then there's other guys selling their feet pics and they're full on just like, yeah, I'm just a skinny white man. People want to see my feet. It's like, why the fuck am I not getting paid to show off my feet?
I mean, you gotta put it into action.
I guess so. But then
You
the
gotta
idea of
start
creating
making
a
an
Twitter
OnlyFans
profile.
and going.
Yeah, the idea of putting all that effort in is what's stopping me. It's just like, I don't know if I really want to have in the back of my mind know that I'm paying my bills through my feet.
All you gotta think about is you're paying your bill.
Yeah, but it's the type of people I'd have to interact with where I'm just like, Actually, I saw my first tail in real life today. Someone actually walked into Walmart with a fucking tail on, and I'm just like, you know okay.
I guess so.
It was after 10:30 at night. I hadn't have shit to say. If you're going into Walmart with a tail on and a matching mask, I might add.
This is the world we live in
This
now.
is the world we live in. I don't want to make light of a situation that does not deserve to be made light of, but do you think, or should, let me rephrase, what are the odds that there's at least one furry in Ukraine right now, like really fighting the good fight in his
Furry.
costume?
Oh, in his
In
costume?
his costume, that's the big thing. Because one of two things, either he either really, really wanted to participate in real life wearing his furry suit, and he's just like, well, this is a good opportunity. Or he wants to strike fear into Russians by chasing after them as a furry.
I honestly feel like there's,
Chance.
yeah, there is a chance.
Now, I'd like to give the same credit to the Russian army, but I don't fucking care about them. Actually, it's really weird living in the world right now because I have sympathy for a army who I don't agree with their politics of why they're going to war. However, I recognize the fact that the soldiers are not the ones making the decisions to go to war, so I can feel bad for them.
Yeah. It's very weird.
Yeah, very
Especially
weird.
with like everyone canceling Putin on Twitter.
Someone made a good point today, and I don't know how relevant this is because I don't know how much the other people use it, but Donald Trump's the only one that got his Twitter banned out of all the crazy people. Well, I should say, out of all the crazy world leaders. Like, Putin still has his, and some guy that was bombing Kazakhstan, I think, or somewhere, another one of the countries that was bombing somewhere else, their leader still has a Twitter too. And I'm like, well, two questions. Like, how much are they posting on their Twitter about the crazy shit they're doing? Or do they just happen to have a Twitter? And like, what's the average user base? Is Americans reading more of their tweets than their own people?
I also imagine it's like more so that Trump had control over his Twitter too. Like,
It was
there
him
wasn't
actually making
someone
tweets.
monitoring him.
Yeah, I can get behind that being a problem. I mean, you don't see Eminem running around on his own Twitter.
Gotta go to Eminem 2 for that one.
Well, don't get me started in that conspiracy theory, because there's been talk about them replacing Eminem a long time ago. You got Avril Lavigne, is all I'm gonna say. And you know what would be the funniest thing is if we found out that all of these celebrities did get replaced by clones, but we found out from Britney Spears. I would be so happy. Like, yes, Queen, tell us all the truths.
Us the goods.
I just saw a picture of her today talking about how she was releasing a book and stuff like that. And I like just looked at her picture for a second. I'm like, she feels like a sister to me. Because, like, I grew, she was probably 5-ish years older than me. But, like, I look at her the same way a younger sibling would, trying to protect their older sibling. And now that good things are happening, you're just looking at them nodding your head like, yeah, you deserve better. This is good.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Weirdest parasocial relationship I've ever had.
I think it's understandable, though.
I feel like people in their, I feel like people around the age of 30 have a slightly different relationship with specifically just Britney Spears than people younger than 25 or older than 35. We were in that age where we listened to her, and then we grew up with watching all our shit happen to her, and now we're adults, and she's getting to be treated like an adult, and we're just like, all right, the world's a little bit more right now. Not by a lot, but just a little. That all being said, I'm going to start broccoli.
All right.
Did I tell you I have a new system for my overlays? Instead of having different scenes for each of my games, I have them all on one source and I just turn off the ones I don't want.
Nice, nice.
Works a lot better.
Yeah.
Except for the fucking
There's definitely
camera.
A lot of different situations that
so one
you
of,
need both for. But...
One of the reasons I did it was because I got tired of my camera being different spots, different sizes and angles and stuff like that. So like
I
I'm
think
like,
you can like copy and paste them, can't you, though?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But that still required me undoing all the stuff that I had done, and I would have led to essentially this anyway. But now... just noticed that my fucking Rocket League box is a different size.
It's all about tinkering.
What the fuck? It's lower. Say.
Over time, you'll get a system for it.
Yeah, I thought I just built that system. I didn't ever want to have to look at it again.
No. It's not that easy.
Streamlabs doesn't even fucking
You'll matter. Learn as you stream more and more and more games and have different events. And...
events? What are you fucking talking?
I mean, you know, maybe you'll have like a full screen camera mode. You'll have a 10 cameras, you'll have different scenes for everything.
Well, if I can only be what BB Jess is now. I went to Streamlabs, I want to be in Stream Elements. I should just get rid of the button. I don't know if I have a use for it now.
Destroy it.
Destroy it. Cast it into the fire.
Okay.
I have to go like this. Full screen this. Pull up OBS. I'm changing it to the two boxes I see. What in the actual? Oh no, it's showing this. Okay, okay. Let me okay. Oh, I have to move the fucking box a frame up and over. And when I fucking click it, it moves off screen. All right, I gotta go down a fucking inch. All the way there first. Save. Oh, 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 it's so close. I'm keeping it. I can fix it better with this. This. This and like pull that down just a little bit. All right, now I'm gonna switch over to the Destiny one and it's still gonna be fine, right? Yeah, I can live. Can I live? All right, can I cut the middle? Here I thought when I was inviting you that I was ready to go. Okay. Happy. That's in the box. That's in the box. I don't even think I have a box for my other one. No, I... Fuck it. Okay. Jeez. About to take some physical damage from that. Not emotional. Alrighty then. Oh, and you hit a mass bomb. That's nice. Do I have stream avatars running? No, I don't.
I don't know. I wasn't sure.
Now, I know I've already told you about the music that I found, but I feel like I have to keep telling you about it now because of how many times I mentioned before and how many times I wanted to find music. I gotta balance that out. All right. So, no, I don't want to cancel. I want you to fucking load. Oh, hey, Kyle's got my stream open. That's neat. All right, never mind. I'll keep it. I was gonna put on all the fucking bots. Well, this is fine. Alrighty then. Press this button. Hey, I think good. Here's your mass pop in 27 seconds. That's one of the next things I'm going to be editing since I put all the prices at one ticket. I put all the timers at 3 minutes. But I definitely think I'm going to probably half the time of Battle Royale. It only takes about a minute and a half for like six people to do a Battle Royale. I think Mass Bomb could be reduced as well. All the Stream Avatar ones, I think, could be reduced. Grab Rave, I feel like I should increase the time on it. Not that I have a problem with Crab Rave, but Jesus Christ, people love doing it. Making me dance. There, they want entertainment. Game loaded. We're making it this far, at least.
Pretty good.
Do you know about the 7-Eleven event that's going on in Rocket League?
Yes, that's... you got the Slurpee one.
So weird to say those words. Okay, so as of the 6th of next month, we'll be able to unlock a hot dog topper or antenna. I think it's a topper. It's a Big Bite hot dog, and it has like all the dressing on it, like relish and ketchup and stuff like that. And then I think it's beginning of April. We unlock the Slurpee decal for the car.
Okay.
Those are the only three items, and it's really taking them 3 months to give them all away.
They gotta milk it as much as they can.
I honestly think about, like, streaming with my work attire on. Just while I play Rocket League. Just title it sponsored content. bringing up the title thing, like donate $5 here in the title. What if I put the title as do not donate? Reverse psychology? You think that would get more people to donate?
I don't know.
I feel like I could get arrested with some of the things I think about for reverse psychology and that kind of stuff. I feel like I might have committed Geneva Act violations of the Geneva Accord. Just off of the ways I've thought about, like, not messing with people, but, like, making them think the way I want them to.
Mm-hmm. So brainwash.
In a way, but, like, more making them think it's their idea. This is why I love Among Us, and there are certain people that love watching me play Among Us. I feel like I'm a psychopath or some combination of those syllables. But I don't want to lose my friendships, because that will ruin people. Oh, man. Anything good in this door? No. I see no Smash Mouth.
It's like one in a million.
I'm looking for that one in a million. I just want that fucking Smash Mouth. I will be buying credits when I can buy that fucking song. So mad I missed it.
Someday.
How'd they even get rights to it is what I want to know.
It's Rock of the Year. They got money.
They got that Fortnite money.
Yep. Especially.
I had someone telling me, like, we were talking about VR chat and stuff like that and how concert's going to be in VR soon, blah, blah, blah. He's like, dude, I went to the Travis Scott concert in Fortnite and it was dope. This is like a grown-ass man. And I'm like, I believe you. Honestly, I fucking believe you.
I heard it was good.
I can't imagine what a virtual reality concert could actually be. Like, the limitless potential that could have. Especially right if it's now, interactable. Woo!
If it's in VR chat, you're not getting good frames at all.
That's true.
It needs to be like a rec room type game or something where everything's limited.
All right, so after work, I went to Walmart, as I said, and I bought a new controller.
Oh.
And I got hand wipes.
Nice.
I want this controller to last longer than...
I believe.
As long as I keep my thumbs clean, that's the goal. In a pinch of full penetrating. So did you play the Arceus update at all?
Nope.
Apparently alphas are spawning in packs.
Oh. I don't know if I would have touched the game for a long time.
They did just announce Gen 9 of regular people?
Mm-hmm. I saw that. Oh, God.
Did you see it? I have to go for this. Otherwise, it's gonna go in. Okay. Everybody Lighting okay over there?
I just had no boost, but I wanted to go for it because it looked nice.
He was driving backwards on the wall. Oh, that would have been so beautiful.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow, really?
Ooh.
I didn't think he was going to be able to get that off the wall.
Yeah, I was.
Back down and had to drive back up.
Very light touch, but it worked. To you.
Oh.
That backflip.
That feels good though.
Yay.
Fuck you. Wow. That was so good. Rest. Damn. Really reaching for it.
Mm-hmm.
Want to do that though?
Too much sauce, too much.
At the play though.
We
get out of here. Steady out here. He gets the goal. Nope. A little rock band there.
Wow.
We get a kickoff goal.
Yep. Here it is.
I got it.
Okay. And it's diagonal.
Yep. Partisan.
No.
I should have.
I maybe okay. had a plan after, but I hit it, but no.
I'm sitting at the bottom of Diamond. It's been a hell of a season.
Mm-hmm.
All over Diamond this season.
I just wish I got champ when they had better rewards.
Ace, don't even fucking ask. Just get in the fucking Discord. Fuck you, asshole. My brother's gonna join us, and that is a fucking honor.
Oh.
Everybody involved. Not only does you get to meet him, but he gets to meet you.
Wow.
Ace, get the fuck over here. And also, get a fucking better headset for your phone. About to join on his phone. Headset. His headset is wireless and connects directly to his Xbox, which is awesome because he has 4K setup and a new Xbox and blah, 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 blah. I bought him the headset.
All right. Hello.
Ace, Duck, Duck, Ace.
Hello, Duck. Hello. I'm Ace.
Ace, Duck has my birthday as his Discord numbers.
That's ironic.
Yep, so I have a pet duck now. Not calling him my pet, but...
I mean, you kind of just did.
The implications.
I'm sorry, Duck.
Just a little bit.
I've been dealing with it for a while. It's okay.
How was you guys' Tuesday?
It was great. I played Witch Queen all day. What the fuck did you do?
I worked, but like it was fine because it was Tuesday.
I covered my shift. I was not working on my only holiday of the year.
It was beautiful. It was a beautiful day. I was very happy.
No, you don't understand, Ace. I had one of those before. It wasn't Tuesday, but it was 6606.
That's fine, but it wasn't Tuesday.
No, but do you know what happened on 6606?
No.
Nothing.
I'm sure nothing's happened.
No, I was sad.
Nothing happened on Tuesday either.
No, Destiny dropped a new DLC. I got to enjoy that.
Oh, actually, Elden Ring came out on Tuesday.
There you go.
Yeah.
No, it was a big day for media, honestly. But
Tuesday was pretty cool, but...
Justin, 6606 is the day I got my stitches out of my thumb. So I had to miss school.
Hey, you got a day off of school. Had to miss school. This motherfucker
asked. No, I was pissed.
He's missing school.
That was the only day I wanted to be at school. Exactly. Exactly. I couldn't participate in that.
I remember going to class on the December 21st of 2012.
I was hanging out with Leo. We were prepping our bags.
Yeah, dude, it was noon, right? It was like directly at, no, it was like 12:21.
Yeah, something like that, yeah.
You were literally going to class, and we're like, yo, so it's gonna happen during this class, y'all ready? So, like, the whole school was just kind of like, oh, we're all gonna die, this is gonna be great.
Justin, I wish I was lying to you when I said me and Leo had a bag packed and ready.
Well, you got to.
Yeah, you know?
Yeah, you did.
Are we packing one this year? Because it's the inverse.
Yeah, it is. Mayans weren't that stupid, okay?
it's whoever translated the Mayan calendar to our time wasn't that stupid. Because they remembered to keep in all the fucking leap years and bullshit we thought we were smart enough to figure out.
It could have been the most brilliant person in the world, but the first person to read the Mayan calendar and be like, yo, guys, this is what it says, could have been dyslexic as shit.
Do you get dyslexia when giving people their change? Because that's the only time I get it.
No, I get it with letters. That was like the worst thing in high school, is explaining to people that I don't have dyslexia, like looking at like numbers or like patterns or something. I have dyslexia like reading words and saying words.
That's a common,
why a lot of times I'll be like,
that's a common form of dyslexia. I didn't know you had that, bro.
Well, no, I mean, like, it's not like that crazy, but a lot of the time I'll be like, if I'm saying like dad bed, I'll be like dead bad.
You know, is it saying or reading?
It's mostly saying, but I'll do the same thing reading occasionally. Okay. But I read a lot now, and it's not a problem. But like, it's a lot more saying. It's like not the same thing as dyslexia, but like I do it fucking constantly.
Going
on. Speaking so quickly.
I have invites.
Do I? What?
Four now, maybe?
Oh, they're through the fucking Rocket League game, not.
Yes.
Yeah.
I can't tell you how honored I am that you fucking popped in here. Not only, like, messaged me if you wanted to play, but in my Twitch and everything. Damn, that car is still.
Well, I was looking at. Yeah, thanks.
You need the colored antenna?
For this one, I might actually have it. I don't know if I do. I usually have these set up. Honestly, I was just kind of like looking through games to play, and then I was looking through something to have on my phone because I usually do like background music or like YouTube or something. And I threw it on Twitch because I seen that your thing was on. I saw you playing Rocket League, and I was like, I just downloaded Rocket League. John got me to download Rocket League. Let's see if I can join.
How dare you?
I uninstalled it because we downloaded it once, and then like 3 weeks later, I was trying to download Conan Exiles, which is like 150 gigabytes.
Shaking my head at you. You're one of the top members of this clan.
It's like a 30 gigabyte game.
You didn't even know we had to change FUDP.
We didn't have to change.
No, we did just have to. They blurted out on us. It was all asterisks. Someone reported us.
Only a designated double penetration.
Goddamn right. But you have to let Deadpool know that my clan. No, I haven't run into Keith yet. I'm thinking Keith is the reason. No, me and Nerdy think Keith is the reason. He's telling people that's what it actually means, not Deadpool.
Okay, hold on a minute. It's an entire genre of pornography. There has to be other people on the planet that recognize it.
You're right, but that's not what the name is. The name is Fuck You Deadpool.
Other people don't know that.
Yeah.
There's a very big genre of people that that and think of something way different. You know?
We think FU got censored. Just the combination of those two letters.
Maybe.
You have to let Deadpool know that my clan going back to Black Ops 2 is now dead.
Finally, he got censored out.
Like, this is an old-ass clan that I've been running for a long time. I'm the only one in this motherfucker, but I'm running it strong, and it's officially dead. And I had to give one last middle finger to him, because he won't talk to me, even though he's in the same city as me. Is he still in Vegas?
Yes, he is. He's the character. I mean, not currently.
I love him, but, yeah.
So he works mobily now, so...
That's good. I don't care what he's doing, as long as he's doing good. Fuck him, though.
Currently. Yeah, he got sent out to Cali. He's like a job site leader, and it's like one of those jobs where like somebody did it wrong, and they called in and were like, "Yo, they did it wrong," and so the job was like, "Okay, Anthony, you're gonna go out there and fucking fix it. We're gonna pay you to go out there,
yeah,
and you're gonna go out there and fix it." And he went out there, and then he got there, and they're like, "This is not the problem that they said it was. I can't fix this." And they were like, "Okay, cool. Chill there while we figure out.
We're gonna send another guy to fix you."
Yeah, we're gonna send another guy to fix it, but you might as well stick around and learn how to fix it.
Hell yeah! So you can fix it next time. Fuck yeah! So
next time you can fix it. Devil's like, "Why don't you just tell me how to fix it?"
Dude, we don't know how to fix that. What?
Because we don't know how to fix
it.
Yeah, exactly. We have a guy for that.
Yeah, right?
He's gonna get there in a minute.
You're the guy for something else. Calm down.
Yeah, and I'm like, "You're getting paid the whole time, right?" And he's like, "Well, for the times that I would be on the clock normally." I'm like, okay.
But they're paying for the hotel, right?
Yeah, they pay for everything.
There you go. He's smart. The only complaint I ever had with him at Site Solutions was when he walked off the fucking site with me and Dan, and we didn't know where he was. And that has nothing to do with work-related. He was great at work. Let's just hope he doesn't have any female problems and he just... disappears. The fucker walked back to the hotel on our first day. He saw the hotel one time. No, this is the store that you got electrocuted at.
Yeah, I know. He didn't even drive. He wasn't even awake for the ride to the hotel originally.
Dexter, how you doing?
I'm doing good. How are you guys?
Hello. Dustin's in here.
I know. I thought that's why I pop in.
I figured. Sorry, Duck. This got way out of control. Dex is the person that me and Ace used to play Minecraft with back in the day. I might have shown you pictures of his crazy ass builds.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah. So that's Dex. He's also making the music we're listening to. And then Ace and Dex haven't actually seen each other in ages.
Constantly about that wizard, Dex.
Yes.
Oh my god.
The angel wings, like, man. The angel wings and the Monopoly board.
No. Monopoly to the death. That was fucking awesome. Yeah.
No, I think one of the ones that
I'm going to start it before we continue talking.
Go ahead. I think one of the best ones that I can remember was the massive castle. I don't even think it was in one of your servers, Dex. I think we were playing with one of your friends that had a server that was equally as crazy, and you were building just like this mega castle, and it was so big that I was just running materials.
Oh,
from
dear.
The blocks.
Oh yeah,
to the site. And he was just building, and by the time he would use all those materials, I would get back with the next load of materials. Just that was the thing the whole time. It was just absolutely insane.
Oh, chicka bell shots. Hello, Ace.
Okay. Hello. Hello. Oh. Oh my god, I'm gonna cry. Beautiful human being. Oh my god.
Ace, I already told them that the only reason me and Dex still talk is because Tink kept saying happy birthday to me on Facebook.
I would say stuff to Ace on Facebook or whatnot. One, he hasn't added me, and then two, he never fucking replies to anything anyway.
No, he's too young for Facebook.
Dude, I was around when Facebook... I was finishing my bonger. When Facebook first started, honestly, I just didn't give a fuck, like...
Yeah, but did you
all
have
my
MySpace?
Friends that were like overly popular? Yeah, well, I mean, like, I had MySpace when it died. I mean, I had MySpace for like a year, and then we all deleted it, like, because it, you know, it was past that. But honestly, Facebook was always just like too popular for me. It was too mainstream. I didn't fucking like it. In high school, I was against that shit. All the popular kids used it and used it to judge each other and shit. So I just didn't fucking care.
I use Facebook for the Messenger.
Right. No, that's all I have now is Messenger, especially because it's for my work chat and stuff. So
yeah.
I literally never touched the app.
I feel like
it's
Facebook
told me
should
uninstall it multiple times.
I feel like Facebook.
I use
really...
Facebook to swipe phone.
I feel like Meta should really focus on the fact that everyone uses it for Messenger exclusive.
Right. Messenger is a great thing. It's basically just texting, but with.
And everyone has had it
right
at some point, so everyone's on that
you
platform.
Just need internet to make a Messenger. You don't even need to pay for it. Nice.
Good pass.
What the hell is that?
It's like one of the best goal explosions ever.
What just happened at the end there?
Watch. It's great.
You streaming?
Yeah.
Oh, right now, by the way.
Yeah, we're streaming.
Oh, that's cool.
So I'm not to mention embarrassing stories about you guys in the past. But
feel free. If you remember them, I'd like to hear them. I got a couple about Ace. I mean, I shaved half my eyebrows when he was born. Unrelated, but it happened. There's pictures to...
Did you do it with a lighter or a razor?
Razor. I was trying to clean up before my first big sixth grade dance and shaved a little bit too much off the eyebrows.
I tried to move it off, my bad.
Literally shaved half the fucking things off. And he was born... like that week. So there's photos of me in the hospital with like half an eyebrow on both sides. I had to make it even.
The only thing I remember about my little brother being born was the moment I was told that he was born, like, because me and dad weren't at the hospital. There was some reason the dad had to stay home while mom was at the hospital for whatever reason. And I had to stay home, or Carol, I don't know. I was home because as soon as I was told Cody's born, I walked right into a dresser. Like, I fucking, like, just face first directly into a dresser drawer. Like,
Cody's
the
memory
moment
equals
it happened.
Pain.
Yo, that's it. That's, I don't remember before or after. I don't remember anything about it. I just know the moment I was told he was born, I walked directly
cold
into
pleasure
a big
playing complex room. Comes into mind.
So here's a funny story. I named Justin after a bully.
Yeah.
Cody, who'd you name?
This is true.
Justin, who'd you name Cody after?
The bully.
Yep.
Kindergarten class.
Yep. But we decided instead of Cody with a C, we're going to be an asshole and spell it Cody with a K. Because my father's name is Kerry and my mother's name is Judy. That makes three J's and two K's in the family. And that's a full house. I know the joke's not funny, but my dad seems to think it's fucking hilarious.
I think it's pretty funny.
He wanted to open up a restaurant, Jack's Over Kings.
Diner would make more sense.
I think he was playing a breakfast diner.
Sorry.
Oh, we are just...
A bed and breakfast.
Oh, a bed and breakfast named Full House, Jack's Over Kings. That's not bad.
As long as it's not one of those, like, you know, motels, shall we say.
Hotel, motel, Holiday Inn?
Yeah, the ones you rent,
the wrong goal,
ones you rent by the hour.
Wait, we'll open it in Vegas and we'll have a bed and breakfast, but it'll be one of the, like, Bunny Ranch kind of things where you can pick a girl. They'll serve you breakfast in bed.
Well, I'm that high. I was just guarding the wrong goal.
I've gotten some pretty good saves on my own goal that I wish I was on the other side because it went directly into my goal. I was close. Also, Ace, do you want slushy as a boost? Like 7-Eleven slushy?
What?
If you look at what's coming out of the back of my car, it's 7-Eleven.
That's... If you tell me that's some crazy thing you got from working at 7-Eleven,
I mean, I am working at 7-Eleven, and I have it. However, you can also have it. Also, nice goal. Nice goal.
Yeah, nice.
Thank you.
Still playing a game here.
That guy really just boosted you so that you could, like, just drive right past him.
He just helped me out.
What a guy, huh?
Nice fellow.
What a nice cereal box.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
A meme today. There's I showed a picture of Cars 1, like the movie. There's Rocket League at low ranks. There's a picture of Airplanes. There's Rocket League at high ranks.
Only Airplanes was good.
Wish that movie was good. It could have been, but you know.
It really could have been. They rushed it, though.
Well, they're just trying to make money off of the same idea.
Right, and if they like given some, if they given some like depth to the movie, it would have been good too. Right. It's the same shit. There's no reason it couldn't have been.
Right. You could have a whole universe filled with that shit. Ours extended universe. Sure, why not? Make TV shows and everything.
But, no, they slashed those tires.
Okay.
Only option I had. For now.
Really wanted that to just slam in the corner. But it looks like it's all the way back.
Oh.
Are we playing Heatseeker?
It felt like it right there. Just back and forth.
Ace, you'll love this one. I closed the store down on Friday nights. So the floor cleaner can, you know, clean the floor. The sign out front, because the doors stay open.
Yeah.
It's closed. Cleaning floors. Woman walks in the store. Like, oh, sorry, we're closed. There's a sign out front. Like, oh, I can't read.
Yeah. Wait. Welcome to America, my guy.
then she gets in the driver's seat of her car.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I'm sitting there like, I'm gonna go back to not driving and being able to read.
Not giving me shit about that. That's too funny, dude.
Customer service life is so fun. What a shot, man. Good game. Woohoo! Wow. And I get another one for the road. Hey, 420!
Did you see the last shot?
Yeah.
I kicked that guy into the ball.
Oh, you got that? Oh, I missed that? Shit.
You got the last touch, but I kicked someone teleported him, and I kicked him into the ball midair.
That's dope. Flip that shit.
Calculated.
That's a good game, guys. Yeah.
Pretty good.
right, so time out for 1 minute. Can we talk about how nobody is more inspiring on the whole planet right now than the Ukrainian president? Like, that guy is a G. What?
I brought this up earlier, Ace, and I'm glad I completely agree with what you just said. But I have to ask you a question.
Yeah.
I saw someone walk into Walmart at 10:45 wearing some kind of furry tail.
Sure.
What are the chances there's at least one Ukrainian guy, or girl, or whatever, fighting that good fight in their fursona?
Oh, I goddamn hope so.
Just to terrify.
What kind of 2022 world in?
That's what I'm thinking.
Do we live in if somebody's not?
Exactly. If there's a war going on, you gotta hope. Especially if everybody's getting handed guns.
Right, the civilians are going in and shit. So, yeah, dude. Somebody's like, got the balls. Let's do it.
Someone's just going like, you know what? I'm gonna go scare some Russians as a wolf.
That's the kind of reporting I want to hear on. Because, like, if there's not, I'm going to be that guy. I'm going to go show up and, like, be that guy. Like, I'm ready. Let's do it.
And that's kind of, I'm not really that far away from where you're at right now. Because, like, I'm not going to lie. The second
I'm
heard...
inspired.
Yeah, the second I heard shit was going down, I'm like, I'm a pacifist. But, like, you know what? I'm about to go start fighting for shit.
I got to intersect right now. The way you guys are talking right there, I was like, I was behind it for, like, 2 seconds. I was like, oh, hell yeah, just standing there, you know, with an AK-47 or something like that, just leveling loads of, like, Russians. That'd be funny. But then I got the ultimate scene where that Indiana Jones scene where he was, like, just swishing the weapon everywhere, and then Indy just calls out his gun and just goes, shut up. Bang.
Just pulls a shoot and turns around. He's like, okay, so we're moving on.
Right? Yeah. He was lying on the floor like, oh, shit.
No, but dude, what a quote. That'll go down in history. This dude's not even fucking 40 yet. He was a comedian before he was a politician in Ukraine, and he gets offered from the U.S. A ride and, like, an export out of the country if they need it, and he says, I don't need a ride, I need ammunition. Like, what?
Russian boat. Fuck you.
Yeah! Russian battleship, this is Ukrainian island. Go fuck yourselves.
Legendary. Legendary.
Yo, last words of gods right there.
Oh my god.
I was talking to my friend about that today. I wonder what that conversation was like. They got that message. Ukrainian island. This is Russian battleship. Surrender or die. They're just looking around like, nobody else plans on getting on that ship, right? Okay, cool.
In Soviet Russia, you can go fuck yourself.
You can go fuck yourself.
Oh man, yeah. And then the woman that walked up to the guy that says, hey, here, put some sunflower seeds in your pocket so when you die at least something good will happen.
Yeah, no, at least so when you die you'll at least be contributing to the planet.
I just watched one today of just two guys stand in front of a tank just talking to all armies, just like, listen, no matter where you go, you're gonna get fucked from every window. He didn't say, I don't think he said the word killed once, unless he was saying that the Russians were killing the children and women, which means they were going to get fucked harder because they did that. He just kept saying the word fucked over it again, and I loved it.
Dude, all the war crimes and shit that's been going on, there's so many reports of war crimes and shit.
When the three nations that are known for staying out of conflict say, hey, no, we're going with the good guys on this one. We're not staying neutral on this one. You know some shit's fucked up. Sweden, fucking Norway, and the other place just said, yeah, we're joining the UN or whatever, NATO.
Dude, even Australia was like, you guys need guns?
Right?
Yeah.
Well, send the kangaroos.
Yeah, we got kangaroos with boxing gloves.
We trained them now. Them.
We weren't telling nobody. Yeah, we weren't telling nobody, but they're ready.
Imagine if you need air support, we got drop bears.
Dude, that would be the craziest world development ever if Australia just comes out the cut, like, takes over all of China with boxing kangaroos that they put, like, VR glasses on and they're, like, controlling. That would be absolutely fucking insane.
All right.
You can start another game.
Yeah. This is the problem I do. In between every game, I'll just start talking. And, well, unfortunately, Duck, with Ace, it's even worse. I love it. Okay. Ace, I have to tell you, I'm contractually obliged to tell you that we might be doing D&D in this server soon.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. I'm going to go with the idea the more the merrier, because this is going to be everyone's first time.
Ah.
Ah. All online. Dex unmuted. What do you got?
Dex, I want in.
I already knew it. Yeah.
Wait a minute, but like, if it's everybody's first time, you got to have somebody...
Nerdy
DM, right?
Nerdy wants to be the DM because he's doing a
Nerdy
writing
wants the DM.
Because he's doing a writing prompt class.
Oh.
Yeah. Creative, okay. Creative writing class, I think it is.
He?
Yeah, he's in college.
Nerdy?
Yeah.
Oh, nerdy, not I'm thinking nervy.
Eh, nervy is also in college though.
I thought Nervy was going to DM, and I was like, oh?
Fuck no!
That's what I was like, oh? I was like,
fuck no! I love that woman, but nah, I wouldn't be able to handle 5 minutes of that shit. No, Nerdy.
I think it'd be entertaining.
Nerdy will be a much better DM than I think I would be.
As long as you're not asking me to DM, I'll play.
This is why I want you to join, because at least be the most experienced person there. I'm not going to be. Dex might be with his excitement.
It's hilarious, man. I'll go from the most inexperienced among my group to the most experienced among another group and just sit there and be like, wow.
Yep. Oh, it's going to be. Think of the most homebrewed thing.
I told you how my first like session went with the group that I DM'd, right? I
who
DM'd
was
a group
in the
in person
group?
Of six people.
Yeah, who was in the group? I remember it was the same time we were playing.
John.
Yeah.
It was John, Mike Savino, Mike Green.
Yeah.
I don't know if you know who those two are.
Yeah,
Mike
yeah.
Green's friend Dale. Steve.
Yes. Yes. This is where I remember
you know
this
Steve.
All happening. Yes.
Steve.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. And honestly, I wish I was a fly on the wall for that, just to see Steve sitting at the table.
Dude.
This is the exact same situation with Mikey. You finding my people that I used to hang out with back in the day. So fucking weird. And I want to say friends, because not all of them like me.
Bro, I spent a week building an entire world for them to live in, right? In a city with, like, easily, like, 40 different encounters or quests or whatever. They burnt it down in an hour.
It took them that long? Rookies.
Well, the 45 minutes was spent interrogating somebody in a basement.
15 minutes, though. Sounds about right. We'll be streaming D&D as well.
Well, that'd be dope. We've currently made it to level 8 in our D&D campaign we're doing. We're running 2 at the same time now. One of the other
people we play with.
Yeah. Have you played 5e?
I can't even remember what I played, dude. I mean, I'm talking like when I was like 12 and 13. I'm like,
oh, yeah. So
that
old it's,
now,
way
bro.
It's way different.
He was playing
now,
right?
Probably 3.5.
There's a bunch of different like editions and stuff. After playing 4E and 5E, and I've talked to people that like are very familiar with most of the editions, and like 2E was considerably like the best like lore based, but 5e is like the best like mechanically when it feels like just playing a free and open game. 4e was cool like when you talk to people and stuff, like that was really nice, but like when it came to combat it was very clunky. I'm still getting used to Rocket League, guys, my bad.
I should have had this. Look how close I was to the spike right here.
I see, I didn't even jump. I was just not used to the pace. My bad.
Oh good.
Well, yeah, fucking 4E just felt like it was like you just had like a list of things that you could do, and that was about it.
What were we playing?
We were playing 4E.
Oh.
That was where, like, in the combat, basically all you had was your list of abilities, and then you could do just like a basic attack. In 5E, the environment is your attack, if that makes sense. Like you can attack however the fuck you want as long as you can roll the stat for it. All you gotta do is say how you want to do it. You have a list of abilities and stuff like that, but it's just way more creative.
It's 2v3. Can I hang back?
Oops. Way too high.
Oh, son of a...
Ooh. That was a nice move.
Got me hard on that. Giggity.
Save me making a joke.
Sorry. That's
cool. Hey, you have the clan name for
Hey. Oh yeah, Giggity Builders.
Oh, Giggity Builders, thank you for reminding me. Holy fuck.
Nice shot.
Ace, did you remember that?
The what?
Giggity Builders?
No, we were Terror Builders.
No.
Last time I was there.
No.
I mean, Nexus? Maybe when I first originally did it, it might have been, by the time I was like a part of it, it was Terror Builders.
Yeah, we were Terror Builders, then Giggity Builders.
Oh.
I might have been out of it by the time it was Giggity Builders, or just out of the loop. It was a good stretch where I played just not no comms. There we go, now I'm getting back into it. Damn, I missed. Watch this first save.
Yeah, if you ever want to play Minecraft and copy stuff again, by all means, you know what I mean? Hit me up.
I would be happy to. Honestly, I would be ecstatic to.
Yeah, we gotta get a PC and get Java.
I would bring half a dozen friends and be like, see? I'm not fucking lying. See? It's...
The legend is real.
See what I'm talking about? Yeah. Look at this shit. Laugh at me now. Tell me it's a kid's game. Look at me again. Tell me it's a kid's game.
You gotta imagine
people laugh at me when I was like... I was like, we were 12. I was 12, and I was in a group that got paid to play Minecraft. Uh-huh. I mean, like on occasion, but they got paid. There was money involved.
Jeez, Louise, pepper cheese.
Oof.
That one hurt my soul. So Ace, on a scale of 1 to 10, what are the chances I'm gonna get you back into Destiny?
You mean like you can pay for it?
I mean, I've paid less. I've paid more for less.
I'm interested in playing the game again because I know that the ownership is switched, but I know it's got a lot better.
Nope.
But
the first sentence is all you had to say. You're done. Download it.
Well, yeah. I mean, like.
That corner is crazy.
Just we're not gonna keep paying for this.
You got Game Pass. You know,
but yeah, that doesn't get you the new shit.
Check.
It's like $80, isn't it?
$40. $50. $40.
I was looking at it. It was like $79.
$50 right now, and then you'll regret. No, actually, $50 right now, and then $10 per season. It's the same exact pricing. You miss nothing out. But not paying $80 right now. $80 is for the special edition that gets you all four seasons. But you can buy the seasons one at a time and you still have to pay the same price regardless. $10 per season. The DLC itself is $40. And I
what's
just...
What's the season? Just like a campaign arc?
Yeah, it's stuff to do each 4 months. Yeah, it's definitely a campaign arc. There's plenty of story involved.
Oh, and that just dropped now, so... If I was to start playing it, I would have to obviously do a little bit to catch up to whatever level we're at now. Just
no.
Crackhead shit. But...
No, you are whatever level everyone starts at now. You're literally a week behind everybody. Nothing.
Stupid.
Yeah, there's that haven't even started their season. I just got nerdy into it.
I'll tell you the same thing I told Josh when he got me to play Call of Duty Vanguard. I was like, I am not going to buy another video game of Call of Duty, but if you buy me a video game and the purpose of wanting me to play it, I will play the game with you. I was like, I don't care what it is, like even Call of Duty. And I honestly liked it. And I told him that I played it by myself constantly and shit, but it was not something that I was interested in purchasing. And same thing with Destiny. I do not want to buy it, but I will play it.
But that's not me saying buy it from you. Minecraft on PC?
He has to get PC first. Oh, no.
If I had a PC, I would be happy to. That would be the second party pressuring me to get a PC, but actually third technically.
There's so many more.
My D&D group wants me to get a PC.
I was pressuring you first, if you remember rightly.
Yeah. Yeah, technically.
Not my fault we lost contact because you wouldn't get one.
Yeah. Oh, you're damn right. It's not.
Justin, I don't know if you remember who Distant Guitar is.
Of course I do.
Okay, good.
Damn it.
That's
a goal. Shit.
That feels like the same exact situation, but reverse. Because he stayed on 360 and never moved forward.
Facts, dude. And by the time we all got there, he was just gone. I don't even know if he...
No, he never moved on. He stopped playing.
Ah, true. I don't know. I didn't know if he ever died. So I was going to say, we all made it, and he just never showed up.
Once a year, I message him on Reddit. He doesn't respond anymore. Just gets sadder and sadder, honestly. The guitar gets more distant and distant each year. I still hear it, though.
Distant guitar.
I still hear it. One day, the song will ring true in my ear again about how much he hates the Vex. Once in a while, I'll still invite Crystal to play Destiny as well.
Just because. This is a loaded question. When was the last time you heard about from Suicide Mike?
I haven't heard from him at 4 a.m. this month. This year?
Really?
Probably have in December. I'd say every 3 months or so, he sends me an Xbox party invite.
Me and Deadpool might have been convinced that he was dead.
Oh, well, I haven't heard from him recently, so...
No, bro, he joined... We had a really big falling out with him one night, because he just, like, kept joining, like, every weekend, just drunk as shit, like, in the middle of the night. And that was his normal shit, and there's nothing against that, man. Like, I didn't do anything. Right, but he joined one night, and he literally just joined the party, and immediately, nobody even said a word. He just started screaming at Deadpool about how much of an awful friend he was, because he didn't invite him to this party.
Oh, jeez.
And we're all just kind of sitting there like...
Oh, jeez.
I'm saying, and Deadpool had enough at this point. I'm saying, he just lost his fucking mind on him, and it was a blowout. And at the end of it, just Suicide left, and everybody's just kind of sitting there. This was like a six-person party, mind you. It was silent. I'm just sitting there like...
So, you want to hear something weird?
That just happened.
I've been playing...
We haven't heard from him since.
I've been playing with someone that goes back to the original Grand Theft Auto clan that me, Deadpool, Mikey, and this other person all met in.
Yeah.
Her name is Classy. She hit me up via Xbox about 3 months ago, and we've been playing on via Discord on Destiny.
Of all that... Yes! Oh, close. Damn, bro, I was trying, my bad.
Yeah, that was a good idea.
I'm still trying to get back into it. So, I'm better at passing than I am shooting.
It's really weird how many people from that clan still, like, available? Is a way to put it, I guess? I think...
See, if I was better at shooting, I would have fucking got that in. Damn it. The spikes. Shit. I'm trying to play more defense. Good block, dude. Good block. It's beautiful.
Oh, sorry.
Are you good? Oh, I missed. Damn it. Oh, nice. Yeah. Yes. No. Nice. Damn it. Nice. No.
What a bullet.
Big no.
How fast was that? 109.
I hope nobody's in the other room listening, because that could be some weird experience.
Oh, no, they're used to it by now.
Yes, no, go, no, yes, no.
Our mom has played Rocket League before.
As soon as I get these controls back under my hands, I might be good at this.
That's how that is. Been there so many.
Damn it. He blew me up.
What a play. People in Rumble are savage.
I'm gonna me because my dog's about to kick off.
Oh, shit. Oh. That's my bad. My fucking controller died. Fuck! I got back at, like, the worst. I, like, 3 seconds earlier and I had gotten it.
I realize the billboards up there have a bat symbol with a date.
Yep.
3/02/22. Ooh, got it. Jesus. I'm looking at the fucking billboards.
Oh my
damn,
god.
Damn, that was cool.
It's alright. Plenty of time to come back.
I was never here to win.
That's how we like it.
I mean, I like it hard, but it's fine.
Pretty hard right now.
Word.
Game is pretty hard.
Speaking of hard, anybody playing Elden Ring?
Me.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
I saw a post that was like, oh yeah, you're playing Elden Ring. Well, I mean, like, cool, but you could be playing something like Animal Crossing or like Mario Party, and like, until then, we still won't consider you real gamers. It's fucking hilarious. Ooh, nice shot.
My boost.
Let me have it.
Ooh, oh, nice. No. Ooh, not nice.
Oh,
good.
Motherfucker. Oh, he stopped it himself. Nice switch, dude.
Oh my god.
Ooh. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Damn, it really hit from the side.
Nice. Oh.
If only.
Close.
Wow. Also intensifies.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We'll pass off.
I was following you. Yeah, I wanted to say it out loud, but I didn't think I could get the call out in time to make it make sense, so I just followed.
That's the only problem I have with callouts in Rocket League. I completely agree with the exact sentence you just said. Fuck. Connected?
Oh, yeah, I feel it.
I feel it too. I just scored.
Nice.
Nope. The ball reset. Nope, first touch. Okay, nothing happened. I mean, like, I don't know. I just watched me score a whole goal passing all three of them. And they were all playing, too. Like, it was like, you two were the only two frozen. And they're just totally reset. Oh, that's cool. No, that didn't happen. Yeah, no, it's fine. It's fine. Yeah, my bad, Rocket League. I'm just fucking stupid. I got a fourth dimension to see and shit that just doesn't occur, I guess. Crazy.
Good game.
Yeah, usually.
They got a fourth dimension.
Screaming, what a save. I saw that too.
Huh, I was gonna spike that.
I mean, it makes sense though. When it comes to like humbleism, as a three-dimensional creature to not recognize a fourth dimension just because you don't want to is kind of fucking stupid. A 2D creature couldn't see a third dimension that we live in. So why the fuck would we be able to see a fourth dimension? It could exist 100%. I think the thing you're talking about, Jake, is they just confirmed it, that it exists, right?
No. I was going to bring up, what dimension is the screen we're looking at?
No.
It's 2D, cool, but it has depth.
No, it's a 2D screen projecting a 3D image.
Yes, yeah, so...
I do a lot.
So that idea. So a 3D object projecting a 4D image.
Right. We don't have we don't have a 3D object that can project things yet, technically. I mean, like, besides like a projector, but that only projects a 2D image. Yeah, but that's projecting a 3D image.
So then the next logical
No, the best thing we have at the moment, is a 2D screen projecting a 3D rendering of a 4D image.
Right. We just need to up the level of that.
Right. No, it takes innovation. That's the same thing that it takes to cure the planet by, like, you know, making plant-based meat. But, you know, innovation. But, there was, like, science that can, like, confirmed with, like, scientific method that there is 100% a fourth dimension. Like, that shit actually, like, 100% exists. There's no argument to it. If you trust the scientific method, that is.
Yeah, that's the question these days.
Right. Like, as far as, like, testing shit goes, though, they're pretty fucking sure. I think that's the cool concept. Like, a fifth-dimensional or, like, sixth-dimensional being could, like, pass through any given space that you're in at any given moment, and you would have no fucking clue. Just absolutely no idea. Could happen to you 1,000 times. It could be happening to us right now, like, 1,000 times per second. That just could be how, like, the sixth dimension exists, and we'd have, like, no fucking idea.
I mean, there's reason to believe there is happening. We just...
Right. Stuff like that, or something to that extent. But
the,
like,
things we already experience and we know of are those things, and we just are looking at them wrong. Can't look at something correctly while you're inside of the box. You don't know you're in a box if you're in the...
Well, they've already measured the fourth dimension as, like, a static time. Time is the fourth. So, like, first dimension is sight, second dimension is length, third dimension width. Fourth dimension would be time, or tenth is it's another word for it.
The time to, like, a fifth dimension.
Right, the time it takes to get from one thing to another. That's like if you lived in a fourth dimensional world, you could, like, look at your dresser and just, like, grab something out of it because you could see through it and you wouldn't have to worry about getting up or moving to it because you exist in all points of time. So you just need to know it's there and grab it. You just need to look at it and grab it. Yeah. Fourth dimension is just like the thing of time. Fifth dimension might be something to do with, I mean, gravity is just the idea of time over length and width. So, I mean, I don't know that gravity could be a dimension, but. That would be the concept, you know what I'm saying? You have to find what would be the fifth dimension.
Well, the power of attraction itself...
At which point, you'd probably be considered one of the smartest people on Earth.
The power of attraction itself could be considered a type of dimension. It's not a dimension, but the effects that it has are so different comparatively to...
Right, but it's only ever caused from the other dimensions, though, so it couldn't really be a dimension in itself if that makes sense.
I shouldn't say attraction and gravity. The repulsion and attraction. The concept of both.
Well, yeah, I guess that drives down to the idea that you're never really touching anything, that there's, like, this light level of oxygen between everything all the time. So, is that a dimension? You know, that whatever causes that a dimension in itself? Because we don't really fully even understand that.
There's concept. Also the, what's it called? The,
Ooh, good save.
Yep, thinking too much about Rocket League, can't finish. That's not a bad thing, but there's not a goal.
Off post.
Oh, I fucking suck. Go to Z.
I'm in goal.
I got this.
Oh.
Nope.
Nice, good clear. Oh, I passed that right to him. Yeah, he couldn't get it though.
Trying to keep it moving.
No, you're good. You're fine.
Just moving away from the net.
Mm-hmm.
All three of them right there, man. If that bounced out to mid, that would have been beautiful. Woo, that was scary. How you doing, Doc?
Good, good.
I got that.
Oh man, I knew I needed to go back right at that moment for some reason.
Ooh, let's go in center. Just not fast enough.
Oh, nice.
I hit it to right where two of them are. So.
For some reason, every time I go to the ball, you just like
there.
Show up right next to me and get it. Nope.
No, you gotta be quicker than that.
Nice shot.
Duck just scores by himself. Very nice.
I thought that was gonna go off a wall. I was getting ready to set up.
They're playing on top of each other.
They are, dude. I've always noticed it's like two of them right next to each other all the mm-hmm. time.
Ask me why I didn't go for it. I don't fucking know. I'm so sorry.
No, it's fine. I didn't either. I was just playing on it back.
It was also 3-0.
So I stayed.
Oh, it's also 3-0. And Duck knows. He's just like, yeah, I'm fucking... I fuck up my kickoff so often now, Ace. I have no clue why. Like 2 months ago, or maybe 4 months ago now, I just started... Oops.
Ooh. Oh, they really fucked that up.
Oops is the worst.
Woo! Oh, come on. We're not going to lose the shutout in the last 5 seconds. All right, we got it. Let's go, GG.
Keep it up.
Oh, ah, no way.
Oh. I was hoping it would pop up.
It was close.
Well played. You can win a casual game, guys. Woohoo.
Hell yeah. Oh, to wrap up what I was saying beforehand, though, I think it's just like the fourth dimension is a great concept, and I'm glad that we discovered that it exists, and it totally makes sense. It just I think it's like ignorant to be like, that's not real.
One of the main reasons I want to get VR is so I can play with 40
just for
objects.
Just not doing it. Oh yeah, the struggle is trying to decipher with a three-dimensional perception what 4D looks like. You know what I'm saying? You like our brains aren't built to see it that way.
The dodecahedron into itself, like the cube within a cube, the that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Exactly. I just want to play with that kind of object.
Well, I guess you can like image it, and you can't see it on a screen. It's very hard to show it on the screen. That's because I mean, once we maybe make like a holographic type of image, we might be able to like maybe make it make a little more sense perceptually. But like, if you can imagine it in your mind, right? If you like close your eyes and picture like a cube, right? It's a hollow cube, but you can see like all the edges of it. You can see perfectly through it, right? And there is another smaller cube inside of it, okay?
Yeah.
And that's what it looks like to you.
Oh, I know.
But you have to picture now every edge outside of that cube is existent with the cube inside of it. So if the cube looks like the big cube is like closer and the small cube is inside of it, there's also a part of that cube that looks like it's outside of it and behind the big cube that exists as well in the fourth dimension. That spot also exists. So does the spot inside the cube and everyone on every other corner and every other side of that cube as well. So there's like a whole external space that you can only see if you're just looking at it a little differently. Like if you close your left eye and look at it with your right eye or the other way around.
Oh, don't even get me started on doing that. That's fun as
right,
shit.
Right, no, it's using that concept. Yeah. It's using that idea of you're seeing something a little differently if you just look at it from just like a millimeter to the left.
Just to add to this conversation.
Imagine seeing all of those millimeters all the time. What's that, Dex?
Don't forget to add to this the perspective effect of proton light. That when you actually observe the experiments that we're looking at, the result is different from when the actual experiment runs unobserved.
Right. And that sucks because if you're trying to do 4D stuff, there's no time involved at all. So like, it's hard to even know what you're looking at when you're looking at it, because it's always changing.
Yeah, because the answer is so broad, because you're not just right. looking at one point, you're looking at every point at which it compares mm-hmm. from. Unless you're tracing a single line of perspective, then you can identify. But the only problem is that doesn't prove everything else, because you can't.
Dex, have I ever told you I love you?
Why?
God damn. No, just yes, exactly. Yes, that was the part that I was worrying to explain a second later, because like, that already didn't make sense. You know, it already makes no sense.
I liken it to the time loop that's explained in every movie. You can linear look along the equation and get a result as you look linear along the equation. But when you try to go and spare off of the equation, the original equation breaks down. So it's kind right. of like that timeline. So the original timeline always breaks away because it becomes shattered into two. So the equation no longer works. But if you follow the equation right the way along, it does prove or does show that the math works. But the problem being is we can't take into account for the extra layers or the extra timelines.
And
it's, yeah,
separate timelines is optional for another dimension as well, because our brains can't perceive multiple time spatial distortions kind of thing. We can't perceive multiple time at the same time. You know what I mean? I can't even word it the right way because we can't perceive it.
In a fourth dimension, past, present, and future wouldn't be a thing. It would just all happen at once.
Right.
We perceive two linear spaces of time as a human being.
Mm. Exactly. Yeah.
We perceive time in a 4-to-1 ratio, and that's when we're asleep. And then when we're awake, we actually receive it on a 1-to-1 ratio, because we're physically, you know, a metabolical clock, if you like, basically ticks forward on that perception. So think of it like the brain CPU frequency here. It's like going up. You got that natural, what's it called? Is it like a circadian? Is that rhythm. The right way?
Yeah, that's circadian.
Yeah, so you got that natural rhythm going on. You've got to take that into account as well.
Astronauts have such a problem sleeping because they don't have their natural indicators for their rhythms. It's not all internal. There's a lot of stuff we receive externally.
Bro, astronauts come back fucked up. That's something that we talk about.
Oh, yeah.
Astronauts come back fucked up. It's not even funny. Like, I'm laughing, but it's really not even funny, man. Like,
they've already sent twins up there. Like, they already know what that shit does to, like, the difference in a human person that is genetically the same. Oh, man. That was a bar.
Damn. On a more pleasant space note, have you heard of the first oxygen that they made on Mars?
Yep.
What did they do?
That's incredible.
They made oxygen on Mars. They found material that could be made into oxygen.
No, it was much simpler than that, and much like way better than that. They sent up the rover. I forget the name. Perseverance, I think. Shit. I missed.
Yeah, one of the ones.
They sent up it was Perseverance 2, because the first one was the one that took those first pictures that were like historic and shit. But it goes up there and they sent this metal box. It's like 6 inches by like 4 inches, and then it's like 3 inches tall. It's like a toaster, basically. And basically what it's meant to do is recreate the process of photosynthesis, where it turns carbon dioxide into oxygen. And that's literally all it's meant to do. And the atmosphere of Mars is 96% carbon dioxide. So all it did was suck in the air from Mars and then pump out 5 grams of oxygen. Just like that.
There you go.
As simple as doing it on like Earth, because like Earth's atmosphere isn't 96% carbon dioxide.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You can't just like do that. But somewhere like Mars, that's incredible. 5 grams of oxygen is 10 minutes for an astronaut, which isn't a lot. But if you do it a lot, that's the first step in like reshaping the entire atmosphere of the planet.
On a side note, Ace, Duck's not on our team.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I'm just waiting. I didn't realize for a bit.
Yeah, yep. Yeah. Took me about 4 minutes. We have 10 seconds left.
10 seconds before the game ends.
Yeah.
Do you think they could actually terraform Mars in that way?
Right, exactly.
what's the implications of actually taking bio? Well, we know like biomes themselves are incredibly complex.
Right.
Oh so my God.
You can't just like
say, it takes take an trees entire infrastructure of not only plant life but animal life to run.
That's literally where I was going to go with that. I was going to say, right, yeah. It's easy enough to say, okay, we'll take trees up there. But the trees require several different species of, like, insect in order to get along with, which will get out of control if just taken on their own without predators to eat those, and then predators to eat those predators, you know?
Right, exactly.
That's just that, you know what I mean? And then if you want the tree pollinated to keep it going, you're going to have to take bees, and then the same cycle again, you know?
Ace. Humanity's got a long way to go, man. I think it's incredible, honestly. Like, I don't know. I think it's something that's really
apologize, but I do have to interrupt for a second. We were just talking about like people in that clan that are still around, Mikey and Deadpool, and that other person, Classy, that I've been hanging out with. We totally forgot someone. You know, just some random. No, just some random Asian.
Oh, just random, dude. He still hops my party occasionally.
He's in like, my fucking Twitch chat right now. Say what's up.
Oh yeah, what up, Asian? He's one of my friend's favorite people.
But the coincidence that he shows up when we were just talking about the rest of them earlier.
Oh, that's hilarious, dude. That's one of my friend's favorite people, dude. He'll just show up randomly to a party that I'm in, and like I'll have like three or four friends in it, and they'll be mad quiet because like somebody random joins, and they're like, "Yo, what the fuck?" And he'll just be like, "What's up, Ace?" I'm like, "What's up, Ace?" And they'll have like a 2-minute conversation. He'll leave, and everybody's like, "Who the fuck was that?" I'm like, "Oh, just some random Asian."
Yeah, Asian Zombie. This is his original name.
Nope. I know, but I just say just some random Asian.
Yeah, just some random Asian.
I love it. Asian. It's my friend's favorite people. What up, Asian? I hope he can hear me. If he can't,
he can. Everyone can. Yeah. You're good.
Hello.
Yeah, I apologize for having to interrupt that, but just the sheer coincidence, the fact that you just showed up, Asian, when we were talking about Deadpool, Classy, and Suicide Mike, all being like still relevant in our world after all these years of the Grand Theft Auto clan we had together, blows my fucking mind. And if you know anybody else, and he's on Elden Ring to relate to what you guys have been talking about.
That's what I was saying. Fuck yeah, Elden Ring.
If you remember anyone else from that clan or the name of that clan from Grand Theft Auto, please let me know.
Another game.
I'm about to. Shut the fuck up. We also need to make sure Duck was in here, which we do. Let's go. Oh, no. Cancel. No more Rumble.
Put us in comp threes.
AFF. Dude, American Freedom Fighters.
You know
Fighters.
What the crazier part about what we were just talking about? Is like we know more about space
than we do the ocean. Oh, don't get me started. Oh boy, I want to know what's down there. I want to know what can kill us.
I'm not nearly as knowledgeable.
I know, I know one thing that's underneath the ocean. More water.
Like what, the Kraken?
More water. American
Yo, you guys
players.
Seen the mega jellyfish?
I believe it exists already.
No, tell me somebody's seen these mega jellyfish, dude. It's something out of nightmares.
Hear
I'm
me
dead
out.
Serious. It really exists, and it looks like a nightmare, dude. I swear to God.
Hear me out. SpongeBob sounds intensifies.
No. No. I mean, like, dude, like, I don't even know how to word it. Okay, so we don't even understand the depths of the ocean yet, right? There's actually some technology that just came out that's using a 3D sonar ping, and then, ironically enough, light laser tech, the same thing they used in the original PSP screen to make it have color.
That's interesting.
They're using those two techs together to map the seafloor. Because they can send pings like the lasers bounce off of the light scan. So they make pings off a light scan. They send the light scan out. It bounces off all the rocks. And eventually in the ocean floor, there's no rocks for it to bounce off of. So it just like dissipates. They send it down with this laser and it bounces off as the laser back and forth all the way down. And then they figure out how far it drops and they can map it that way, if that makes sense.
Oh, you didn't think blowing up seafloor on the seafloor was a good idea?
No. No, they tried that and they couldn't map the explosions because it goes down so far. But yeah, they're really trying that.
That's going in. I don't care. Oh, I gotta deaf him for a second so I can talk to Asian. Who was Jesus? Jesus something. Oh, dirty Jesus! Yes. I'm hanging out with Classy. Classy, what was her full name? Classy Avenger. Classy something. I just know where it's Classy now. I can't think of the full. You have a good memory though. Conan Girl, Ponderosa. Ponderosa the leader? Ad popped up. Yeah. Understood. Subscribe so you don't have ads. You have a crown next to your head. Oh.
Noise cancelling earphones off on one ear so you can hear it. just about caught it like through like the people talking. I was like, shit, what's that weird ass whistling noise?
What
like,
is oh, that fucking sound? What's going on? Like, what right? Is
I was about to say, guys, what the fuck's that noise? And then I looked over and the cat was just like,
hear that? Like, what's going on? That's funny as shit. Dude, I did that the other night, and I'm not even trying to blame anybody for leaving the stove on or anything, but I smelt something. I'm sitting there playing Xbox, and I'm just like, damn, that smells like something burning. Like that, I'm like, hold on, that's like a decently concerning amount of burning smell. You know what I'm saying? Like that's someone downstairs, and I get down there, and my dad's standing at the kitchen sink, which is like to like the left of the stove. So yeah. He's just or the right of the stove. Either way. He's just chilling there at the sink and he's just washing some dishes and behind him the stove is just in a plume of smoke. And I'm like, hey, what the fuck's going on behind you? And he turns around, he's like, oh. And I'm like, what do you mean, oh, dude? And then the fire alarm starts going off like almost like as perfect timing and I'm like, yeah. there's a fucking flip smoke. What's going on? I guess there was some like caked oil and shit on one of the burners on the top. So when it turned on, it just started burning. And you know, all you gotta do is turn it on to let some water boil and then just start washing some dishes to not see that. And
yeah,
I'm like, you don't smell it? And he's like, nah, it's right next to you. It's a black cloud of smoke. I'm like, what? Like, I came from upstairs, motherfucker.
Is he a descendant of Bob Marley? Is he used to that much smoke, you know?
I don't, dude, he's a chef, so I mean, like...
Mm.
Or, I mean, he used to be, so he's grown up, or not grubby, used to the smoke smell, but like, fuck, man, I was...
Yeah, he's used to flambeing and stuff going on around him, so he probably doesn't even associate that smell, you know?
What the hell? These are the same people that set the smoke alarm off making bacon, though, so, like...
I'd burn boiled eggs, me.
I'd burn water.
Well, I swear to God, dude. I swear to God, I must have been like at 13 or something, and my mom burnt sausages in the microwave. Like pre-frozen Link sausages. She burnt them in the microwave. I'm like, how the fuck do you even do that? Like,
bro, you don't have true memories of her making hockey pucks.
It should just explode, shouldn't it?
No.
How would it burn?
Do you know what I mean by hockey pucks? Like, do you have a visceral memory in your head of eating hockey pucks?
No.
Okay. So, back on Belmont Street, like, literally before we moved to High Street.
The only thing I remember on Belmont Street was getting yelled at because I didn't clean up my room right enough. And it was because I left the Connect 4 lying out.
Sure.
That was it. That's my only memory of that place.
So she used to cook burgers on the grill out on the back porch. She didn't know that there was a high and low switch to the propane.
I remember her telling me about this.
So it was set on high from dad cooking steaks. Searing the steak as he's done.
Shouldn't it be set back down to low before he shuts it off?
Talking about dad.
Okay. Yep, fair. Continue.
So she thought that's just how you cook burgers. And for years,
yeah, it must be on high because it's supposed to be.
For years, I thought that's how burgers were cooked.
Bro, I almost killed me and Cody one morning. I'm telling you that. This kid woke me up at 10. Mom and dad both had work or some shit. They were not home, and I was supposed to be watching Cody. And it was like this for like a good couple of weeks. We were on Day Street, and this was like this was the summer that you were locked into your room and didn't give a fuck about the world. So I was charged with watching Cody.
So, yeah.
I might have almost killed all three of us. I couldn't even tell you if you were in the house or not, honestly.
I might have been having sex at that moment. Weren't home.
I have no idea. Cody woke me up, and he was like, dude, you need to make me fucking breakfast. I'm hungry. He was like 9. You know what I'm saying? Like, he was like 8 or 9. You know what I'm saying? He's like, I am fucking hungry. Somebody's got to make me breakfast. I'm eating breakfast right now. You're making me breakfast. I was like, okay, fine. What the fuck do you want? He's like, I want cinnamon Pop-Tarts in the microwave. I'm like, fine. I wake up. I grab some cinnamon Pop-Tarts. I throw them in the microwave. About 10 seconds later, I realized I did not take the aluminum foil off of the cinnamon Pop-Tarts before I put them in the microwave. And the aluminum foil. No, dude, he literally.
It's not even like we have a toaster oven.
Dude, I just
like we had toasters our entire life.
He just wanted them in the microwave, man. I was half.
Oh, in the microwave too.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I put the entire package of Pop Tarts just in the microwave on a plate, and it started sparking and shit. And I'm like walking away because Cody knows how to open the microwave when it's done, when it beeps and shit, and put it on a plate and eat it. So I'm just walking away, going back to my room, and Cody's like. I turn around and like, what do you mean? And I just hear and just sparks flying in the microwave, and I'm just like, oh shit!
Dumbass.
Dude, it was one of the best moments of my life. I'm not gonna lie.
Ready up.
Highlight, you know, just it's a remembrance of always double check. That's the moment that always reminded me to just.
I've had a similar moment where I've been watching our. I've been upstairs doing stuff, and then Tinkerbell's like, oh, shouting, oh my god, oh my god. So I'm like, okay, what the hell's going on? I go running down the stairs, and there's Tinkerbell with the grill pan on fire where she's been cooking some sausages, and the fat in the grill pan's caught on fire. And she's literally just about to turn on the kitchen tap onto this fat
oil. No.
No,
you're just like lunging for this flaming thing in her hand.
Right?
Don't do that. Don't do that.
Yeah, I couldn't have been any closer if I tried, trust me. Oh my god. It was just like gone up in flames, no doubt, honestly.
Yeah.
It
would have been just so much worse. She might have hurt herself, honestly, if she just threw pressure, faucet on it. Yeah, that could have been really bad.
Ace, I'm gonna throw a couple more names at you, see if you recognize any of them.
Okay.
Jedi.
Oh, of course. DGAF. I talk to Silver constantly. No.
DK Mercy.
Yeah.
QB.
Oh yeah, of course QB.
I haven't talked Mercy, to. Of course. Yep. I haven't talked to any of these people in fucking 5 years or more.
Oh, dude, I could connect you with Silver tomorrow.
If any of them play Destiny still.
I don't know if Silver does, but Silver is chill as shit, dude.
Let me put it this way. If you see any of them, let them know I said hi and I miss them.
Nobody asks about you more than Rob at Fresh Shop.
And that is the
And other people
thing.
Do ask about you, but he constantly.
You know what's funny, though? I message him on Facebook and I let him know I'm streaming on Twitch. Never seen him in here.
I gave it to him a little bit ago.
I've sent it to him myself.
He was really thankful.
I'm so curious.
That was 2 days after I gave you that follow, and we had the one day where I just chilled for a couple hours watching it.
That's even better.
The next day, I handed it to him because I was like, "Yo, I was just on his stream. He's back to streaming and shit. I know you wanted it. Here it is." He was like, "Oh shit, cool, fuck yeah."
Crazy.
Sick.
I mean, I don't
He's
ever
a manager
expect...
now.
That's even better. He deserves it. He's been there a long
time. Time out. He, sadly, they don't treat him like a manager, but they do when they want to go home.
Uh-huh.
And they're like, oh yeah, Rob's here.
Uh-huh.
It's okay, it's a cool fallback when somebody's like, why didn't this get done? And I'm like, well, because I tried to get it done, and Rob was here, so I couldn't.
That's a whole excuse, and I love it.
Yep. And I know Rob doesn't give a fuck, too, because he's like, dude, I can't
That's
do
exactly
it.
Exactly what he would say. He's like, I was here. What did you expect me to do?
Yep. I can't do it. Dude, he tells us, he's like, don't call us up unless somebody's like literally dying. You know what I'm saying? Like, unless somebody's like absolutely pleading for a manager, I do not want to be bothered. We're like, understood. Yeah, absolutely. I wouldn't want to be either, sir. Got it.
I wonder if Tom comes into the store incognito just to see how it's doing.
No. Nope. That man, Tom Sullivan, lives far, far away. I don't know that for a fact, but
he lives far, far away now.
I would. Shit, dude. Fuck all of that. You know who does come in, though? Fucking Melissa. Oh, not Melissa. Jesus. Holy shit, I'm totally blanking on her name. The store manager.
Sure. Oh, shit. Asian. I was about to say thank you so much for saying that, but now I have to sing for you. Do a little one. Do a little 15. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever bring you down. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever bring you down. Best around. Nothing's gonna ever bring you down. I don't know why I went falsetto on all of it, but
Discord.
Sorry.
Don't worry. It's always Rocket League.
Asian, thank you so much. I've always been a fan of you as well, so I appreciate you coming by and hanging out. Didn't have to subscribe, but I appreciate you even more now. You know, Twitch Prime just missed a lot of memes. They could have made it 350. Maybe about 350.
Paying you $350.
they give you $250 now for every subscription.
Hold on, that's what I'm saying, but that would require paying you a whole extra dollar.
I know. But memes,
no,
though.
No.
But memes, though. Thank you, Asian. You're the best. I promise not to sing for you if you don't want me to. I'm going to get so many less subscriptions because I do that. I have fun.
Whee! I'm glad I donated.
Yeah. Yes. The better way to get money. Oh, speaking of donations, I fixed the problem I had.
I am sorry.
I fixed the problem I had where you didn't show up on screen that you donated, on the bottom bar. That's fixed now.
Oh, yeah.
That's fixed now.
Dude, I was so shocked that Jake just missed that save that I didn't even try for it. I just watched it roll in. I was just like, oh my God, he just missed that and just did nothing. I was sitting there as his backup and was just so used to him just always getting it. Just did absolutely nothing.
Fuck. The one time he realized I needed to do something.
He had one job.
I just watched it too. Like, I realized while it was rolling out, I was like, wow, I should really get that. Like, damn, like, I should really be doing something about that right now. But he really just missed that. You know what I'm saying? Like, holy shit.
Look,
like,
that's his fault. But I'm not getting that right now. He should have
been. Yeah, I'm really here for that, but I'm not.
Not my job description?
Oh, that's actually... No, dude, I actually not like anything like that, but this kid comes up to me today, and I work in retail for Duck that does not know. And so I'm at a grocery store where this just random kid, he's not like a kid, but he's more acting like he's like 15. And he's like, hey, I lost my cell phone. It was a black iPhone 11 and had a cracked camera. Did you find it? He said it just like that. And I was like, no. I did not find it. I was like, I can go check in my lost and found though and see if we did find it. And he was like, okay. And I was like, all right. So I'm walking over to the desk. I open the desk. I walk back there. I open the cabinet. I look. There's no iPhone in there. I walk to the front of the desk. And as I turn around to open like the door, it's like a half door so I can see over it. His mother is standing between me and him. And she's just shaking her head at me, just eyes glaring at me like, no. Like, no. And I'm like, I just looking at her. She goes, his sister has the phone. Like, what is happening? Like, in my head, I'm like, what is going on? And she's like, we're just teaching him a lesson. We just wanted him to know that it's gone. And I was like, oh. And she's like, yeah. And I just like looked over her shoulder. And I was like, nah, buddy, we don't have your phone. It's gone. And she just looked at me and goes, good. I was like, what the fuck is happening right now? I was like so terrified, dude. They left and I'm like, what kind of shit did I just go through? I was like, that was so fucked, dude. It was so fucked. But in hindsight, it was hilarious. Good lesson by the mother, but man, was that shit creepy, dude. It was creepy as shit. I had no idea what was going on, man. I turned around and she's just shaking her head at me, just glaring at me, no. I'm like, what do you mean, no? What do you mean no? Like, I know, that's what I was trying to tell you. We don't have it. Like, yeah. I just look, we don't have the phone. How do you know that?
Like, what do you mean you know that already? Yeah, Hold on a second.
Like, I was a little scared. I'm like,
she's shaking her head no, you're nodding your head yes for some reason now.
Yeah, exactly. I'm like, yeah, exactly. Yeah. What? And she's like, dude, she didn't say anything. The first thing she said to me, the first words out of her mouth is, his sister has the phone. And I'm like, wow, you know a lot. I'm like, you know a lot about what's going on, woman. I didn't even talk to you. Like,
I didn't know you were involved in this.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I thought it was just this dude. Like, his sister's standing back there with him. He looks worried as shit. I'm just like, wow.
A brand new assessment of the situation.
Yep. And then, like, inside my head, I'm like, oh. The kid's, like, pleading at me. I'm like, nah, bro, we ain't got it.
You had to do a few mental gymnastics.
No, dude, her looking back at me, she's still, she's, like, nodding with the same intensity that she was, like, shaking her head before. She's like, good. I'm like,
you could hear her thinking, good, like, good.
No, she said it. No, she said it. She literally out loud was like, good. Like, what would happen if I didn't say that? You know what I'm saying?
What if you had a different person's black iPhone?
No, not even that. What if I just looked at the kid and was like, yo, no, your sister has it? She was looking at me with that eye with like, I'm glad you played along. It's better for both of us. I'm like, whoa, what?
Did anyone have to hurt you today?
Yeah, like, no, it was fucking sketchy, man. I've dealt with drug addicts. She was perfectly sober and has scared me more than people with needles in their hands.
It's going to be having nightmares about the clerk. You like, don't know him.
Bruh, no, I've had people with needles in their hand come at me, and that lady scared me more than them. Like, damn, bruh.
Get that kid a job.
No. He didn't even realize his sister had his cell phone, like,
where would he have lost it? How do you lose
in the store somewhere?
Yeah, how do you do that?
He probably left it somewhere. And by what she was saying, they were teaching him a lesson about losing his phone because he had lost it that many times. And so they probably like lost it, and then they went to go look for it, and she found it. It was like, yo, I found his phone, and she was like, okay, good, don't tell him. let him think it's gone. You know, we'll let him learn his lesson. Because that's what she said to me. She was like, let him learn his lesson about the phone. We had it, but he thinks it's gone. And we're like, okay. Okay, lady, what? Makes sense. But how do you not tell your sister's pulling some shit on you like that? What are you, stupid?
Yeah, he lost his phone.
He
must lose it that often that she's just like drew a line in the sand.
Exactly, she's like, finally gotta teach him an actual lesson about what it's like to be gone.
Yeah, I think she's probably rebought him about 5 or 6 of them and just gone, you know what? Hell to the no, I'm not buying you another one.
That was me and iPods back in the day.
Yeah. Mine was the same with Walkmans. I was always on my bike and I'd go over a curve or something like that. The Walkman would fly out my pocket, smash on the floor.
Makes me feel better. I still deal with that problem today.
Dude, I said Walkman in the party the other day when I was talking about listening to something on the walk to school. And one of my friends literally was like, what's that? And I was like, what do you mean, what's that? And he's like, what's a Walkman? And I was like, and there were a couple other people in the party that were like, what? like what? Like, you're kidding, right? Like, no, don't do that. that's not okay.
Yeah? There are people asking these days how to burn CDs.
It kind of hurt a little bit.
How the f*** do you think I feel?
I know, they were like, they said, what's a Walkman? I'm like, bro, you went to school with me. You graduated in my high school class. What do you mean, what's a Walkman, motherfucker? Hey, damn.
They're going for the bump. There you go. Oh,
oh!
Got robbed, Duck. You got robbed.
I'm sorry that I wasn't there to follow up. I was just making that precautionary save. Like, I was way back. Yo, one kid said to me the other day, and I swear to God, I might have heard him wrong, but I swear to God, this 6-year-old kid was like, Bati. I was like, what? I was like, what? Motherfucker, what? Like, what? And when he said it, his mom literally shrugged at me like, she's like, I don't fucking know, man. Like, I don't. Like, don't ask me, dude. Like, it's understandable. But, like, I'm just worried that, like, that's the new, like. Damn it! Fuck!
Dog good. Dog good. A good
Duck,
game.
I'm sorry I suck.
It's okay.
I'm not sorry, Ryan.
My life is wasting away here trying to teach these dudes to play Rocket League.
Hey, we got best 2 out of 3. I don't know if it was the same exact guys, but I know one of them is the same.
I think so.
I should have saved that.
How are we not partied up, Duck? How did that happen?
It just disconnected me.
Oh. Nope, One Punch Man. Inch Man.
Yo, Jake, I almost quit the other day.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, God.
Well, my manager quit a while ago, so Amanda became the CSM. I don't know if I told you that. You obviously know who Amanda is. She was like the assistant manager. Yeah, she became the CSM, which I'm totally okay with. But what I wasn't okay with was when her and James, which is the, I don't know if you were there when he started managing, but he's the new Amelia. That was the word I couldn't think of earlier. Name, sorry. They both pulled me into the office and they're like, and it started with them pulling me off of register because they wanted to talk to me. And now I'm only on register because it's like fucking super busy. So I'm like on register helping people. And one of the other supervisors comes up. It's like, yo, they want to talk to you in the office. He's like, so I'm going to hop on for you. I'm like, you're fucking kidding, right? It's like super busy. This is really what they want to do right now. He's like, yeah. I'm like, oh, okay. So I walk in and the first thing he says to me is like, so you have 3 call outs this year already, huh? And I'm like, no. I'm like, no, what do you mean? He's like, yeah, you do, I guess. And I'm like, what do you mean, I guess? I'm like, no, I. And it was obviously a lot more like, straightforward than that, but basically he started accusing me of having 3 callouts. I told him I only had 1 and I asked him to see the other 2 and he was like, we don't have them right now, but I'll get them for you. And I was like, well, what kind of shit is that? Why am I here again? There's people out there I like need to be working. And he's like, so why don't you work on Fridays? I'm like, because it's the day off that I like to have. I have one day off a week. I'm here like 40 hours a week every other day of the week. It's just the one day I like to have off. And he's like, yeah, I like to have Saturdays off. But what happens if your manager needs help on a Friday? I was like, then I'd come in and help on a Friday. I was here last Friday. I'm going to be here tomorrow on Friday. What? Why am I here again? And he, and then he's like, you haven't been working hard enough, I guess. And for the second time, I literally was like, what do you mean? I guess. I was like, I'm in the middle of doing my job. Like, I was kind of disrespectful. I'm not going to lie. Like, I was like literally in the middle of doing something, and they called me in and then just started saying that I wasn't doing something. And I'm like, motherfucker. And they got through badgering me and shit. And after defending myself for a good minute, I was like, I realized that like, no matter what I said, it was just back at me. Cause I literally eventually what I said, I was like, do you want me to train somebody else to help me with ordering shit? Cause I can do that. And he was like, you just need to plan better. I was like, okay. He's like, okay. I was like, okay. He's like, do you have anything you want to say? Like, air it out, clear the room. No. And he looks at Amanda, who's the only person that understands everything he's been saying to me this entire time is bullshit, because she's the person that gets me to do all the shit he's accusing me of not doing. And he's like, is there anything you want to say? And she goes, no, I think you covered it. And I just walked out. Like, I didn't know. I just walked out of the room. Got back and registered. My friend was like, are you good?
No, not really.
Yeah, I'm good. How you doing today? Good. Welcome to Price Chopper. Yeah, absolutely. What's going on? I was ready to quit, dude. I talked to one of the other managers about it, and he talked me into staying just for the fact of staying. Like, I'm looking for another job, man. I can't wait to quit, too. They're going to try to get me to stay. We'll give you this. We'll give you that. Nah.
Who was the manager?
I don't work hard enough. His name's James. He's a super chill guy. I'm gonna be 100% honest. I really like him. Like, he's a great manager. You know what I'm saying? Everything aside from that one thing, and I don't even think it was his fault. You know what I'm saying? I think Amanda went to him and wanted him to say that kind of shit, but I don't understand why. You know what I'm saying? It just doesn't make sense, but he seemed very, like, just, here's what I was told. I'm gonna say this about it. You know what I'm saying? That's why I kept being like, what do you mean, I guess? You know what I'm saying? Like, like if I'm getting yelled at, like, say it with your chest, motherfucker. Like, I don't know, like, am I doing it or am I not? Like, you don't come in on Fridays, I guess. I'm like, do I or do I not? Because I'm going to be here tomorrow, dude. Like, what are you talking about? Somebody told me that they were planning on asking me to step down from part-time, full-time. And if they do, I'll be like, perfect. You guys saved me a hell of a lot of time. I quit. Just walk out. That's a 2-week notice I don't have to give. I mean, it kind of sounds ignorant, but I live in like an American town that is striving for people to work jobs at the moment. I mean, there is literally like easily 24 buildings within a mile from my house that are looking for people to work in. Maybe 2 miles, that's a stretch, but.
Oh, jeez.
That was rough.
They fucked up. I'm kind of like speechless and shocked right now, because I'm sitting here like, how do you. Where. I'm humming like really hard.
There's no way, right? Nice. That's a game.
Fuck Wahbug.
My
Ace, let me hear your best Boston accent. Or Worcester accent.
Wah.
Really?
Why? Ah, why is it leaving? My voice is a Boston accent. How the fuck am I supposed to?
Dude, you don't have a Boston accent. You're not going to pack a car and have it, yeah, and go see a Sox game with Matt Damon. They'll tell your ma that you're going to get donkeys for her. Are you even were you even born in Worcester?
He sounded like Brad Pitt in Snatch.
Yeah.
That's more like a Southie accent.
That's the whole Boston accent, is just a Southie accent.
Not necessarily, though. That's what I'm saying.
The only, like, the only more Boston accent is an Irish accent.
Well, no, that's kind of what I mean. Like, the accent in Boston, the Southie accent is like, that's like Southie and around Southie, but like everywhere around that is just what we speak. It's like basically very close to a Boston accent. We don't equate our R's very hard either.
Yeah, but anyone outside of Massachusetts...
I mean, I do.
If you say you're from Massachusetts, they say, oh, you're from Boston? Because they think the entire state
right, well,
is
no,
Boston.
Well, that's the social perceptive of it, but really, it's just, like, that accent only really, like, is found, like, hard like that in Southie and around Southie. Besides that, it's more of, like, a Worcester kind of accent, if you want to, like, get...
Worcester does have a hard Southie wannabe accent.
That's more what I mean. Like, we have a Worcester accent, and that's what you find a lot in, like, northern Boston.
Just this way we say Worcester is the accent.
Yeah. Right. All right, this is probably gonna be my last game. We'll hop off. I got work in like 6 hours.
Sounds good, buddy.
Bye everyone, have a great day. Yeah, it's still laughing, but that.
Guys, what a dunk. That was beautiful. He would have saved that. Absolutely. But nope.
No. Oh, that was a nice shot.
He tapped it right over. Oops.
Oh.
I should have kept pulsing it.
You just flipped it back. That was my bad.
Oh, good flick.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. Oh, nice shot. Good save. Ooh. Ooh, shit.
Nice shot.
I sort of watched it.
Perfect flop.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Right in there. Fuck.
Swoop.
Nice.
Great pass.
Thank you, thank you.
I ran out of boost. I had more.
Oh.
Dude.
Oh.
Sorry, Ace.
No, it's okay. It wasn't your fault. I missed it. Touch. Nice.
Fucking bumped. Ah. I wanted to go for the pinch and I was slammed down. Great. Beautiful.
Let's beautiful. Go!
Beautiful.
It's a boomer.
End it.
Fuck yeah.
Ace, remind me to show Jelly that octane.
Okay.
That'll be my last rocket.
Yeah. All right.
Y'all have a great night. Later. Good talking to y'all.
See you later, brother.
Later. Later, Jake. Talk good to meet you later.
You too.
I head to bed myself. Coming a nice long streak.
Alright.
Alright, brother. Thanks very much for the company.
I appreciate y'all being here.
Alright, speak to you again,
sir. Have good sleep. Good day. Oh, boy.
All later.